Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Wrestling Revolution 3D. So today, we're back, we're playing some more extremely hard difficulty. That's just what we're on now, apparently. I swear I shouldn't be on this. I should be like one lower, but you know what? That's what we're doing. So, Ethan McLeod here, he's got a manager now, and what is he? Some sort of tag team champ or something? I don't know. But evidently, I'm going to cut a promo here. So, let's see what we got to say. Meg Knight, I know you're watching this match behind the scenes. Oh, gosh. You're not supposed to call women that. Man. So. Hopefully. Maybe she was the champ. I don't know. Whatever. Anyways. So we got to take this guy down. I'm thinking. Like I said a second ago, I am on extremely hard difficulty. Whoop. That ain't good. We need to kick out on that. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Ow. Oh my gosh, I missed both of my things. There we go. We had a good opponent, one that we can hit with a spinny kick. Some guys just don't get hit with the spinny kick, and it's annoying. So. Whoop. Nice dodge. Whoop. That ain't where we want to be. Nope, 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 no. There we go. So, guys, how you doing? I'm doing good. I think last episode was pretty frustrating, but it was just because I'm bad at this, and I need to get better. We're going to get better, though, like I said. Oh, my God. Gosh, we just got clotheslined the heck out. See, the thing is, in this difficulty setting, you lose so much momentum every time you get hit. And it's not just you lose momentum, you lose your stamina, you lose a lot of health. You lose health way quicker than you're able to dish out punishment, which is very, it makes it difficult. And they reverse, like, everything. So, we've gotta get better, gotta get quicker on the draw, and get a better understanding of what our stuff does. But that's what you do. Oh my gosh! So, shout out for today, Brian Pixman. I assume, if I recall, he changed his name a few times. But yeah, I think that's who I'm talking about, right? See, it makes it really difficult for me if I'm trying to do shoutouts and stuff, if people keep changing their names. Dang it. But, hi Brian, how you doing? Yeah, Brian Pixman. I think it was Hickman last time, so there are several Brians who watch my videos, I assume. Oh my gosh, ow. Don't like this. Get up. Yeah, see, I lost so much momentum doing that. Whatever. Okay. Let's go ahead and get him back. Dang it! Stay put. There we go. We clipped him with that one. Oh my goodness. Why is this so difficult? Okay. Come on. Okay, here we go. We're getting back. Ow. I was like, oh yeah, we're definitely getting back into this. Dang it. But he is, he's hurting me, guys. Hurting me bad. Come on. We can get out of this. Okay, good. There we go. We sat on his face. That didn't work. Dodge that. There we go. We're getting there. We're gonna get him. I hope. This guy seriously reverses every. Well, yeah, it's just everybody in this difficulty reverses everything, but still, it's difficult. I'm mad at him for it. Really is difficult to build up your finisher meter. Oh well. I suppose that's to be expected if you're on the max difficulty. Whoop. Aha! You thought you had me there, didn't you? Oh my gosh, he did have me there. Okay, time to hit this guy. It's time for you to stay down. It's over. There we go, guys. We got a convincing win. That's what we wanted. I had been losing some matches. We need to stop doing that. Yeesh. Get out of my ring. Okay, good. I'm happy about that. You guys have no idea how stressful it was losing matches. It really was. It was like just eating away at me. It's okay, though. Why is my lifestyle so expensive? Whatever. I don't know why the price on that went up, but whatever. We're trying to earn 3 mil here, guys. If you didn't watch, I think it was last episode or maybe the episode before that. Yeah. I decided on the goal of 3 million, which I think is going to be a good goal. It's going to be something that we can do. Ultra Bull, that's Vader. Minotaur Spooky. Okay, so what do we got going on? One-on-one match versus Jerry Buckler. Let's go ahead and raise our stats. We need to raise our toughness. Toughness, please. I seriously want to get that up, just because I want to be tough, you know? I want to be a tough guy. This is a fighting business. We should be tough, right? Come on, keep going. Go, level 2. Hey, we hit level 2. 83%. I feel like that's actually down from what it was the other day. So, we're going to go ahead and wrap this up. Let's go back, and we should be good to do this match. Jerry Buckler, bring it. I can fight you. I'll fight you all day, bro. So, what do we got? By the way, thank you to everybody who watches this series. I'd say it's my second favorite series to record, and I don't say that as, like, an insult to it. Pokemon's my favorite, just because Pokemon's always been, like, my favorite game. Okay, let's target this guy. Whoop! That didn't work at all. Ow. Well. Okay. We need to start hitting this guy. Not really sure what happened there. Oh, ow. Yeah, that was weird. Whoop, I'm back in the ring, apparently. That was really weird. I went to target him, and it ended up targeting the ref. Then I targeted myself, as you do sometimes. And then he ended up, like, just... And I was trying to walk the opposite direction to avoid, walking straight into him while I didn't have him targeted. And had to, are you kidding me? That's not something you can do. Okay. Ref, move. Dang it. That ref was in my way. I was trying to get to him so I could start laying the smacketh down while he was on the ground. But yeah, anyways, like I was saying before, thanks to everybody who's, watching the series and leaving comments and stuff. That's my favorite part of doing YouTube, is reading YouTube comments. Even though I know sometimes YouTube commenters get a bad rap. Oh yeah, I need to get back in the ring, like, ASAP. So is Jerry Buckler, like, Jeff Jarrett, or what? Whoa! He hurt the ref. Oh, come on. He was supposed to jump. Well. Okay, so I'm not doing so hot here. Maybe, trying to... Ah! Well. Why is he so fast? Oh my gosh. This difficulty. I feel like it was a mistake. It's so, like, nobody stays still long enough for me to hit them. And they're able to just start throwing attacks as soon as they hit the ground. Ow. That was just me missing. Which happens sometimes. There we go. We need to hurt this guy. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this guy's supposed to be Jeff Jarrett. I've never been a big Jeff Jarrett fan. I know there are some people who just, like, absolutely love him. I know he's one of those people. He's such a mark for himself, which is, I try not to use that word because it's like an insider wrestling term, and I'm not an insider wrestling guy, but he seriously loves himself way too much. He broke 1,000 guitars, never drew a dime. If you like Jeff Jarrett, you know those words well. And you're probably none too pleased with me for saying them. Also, sorry I hit the ref there. I apologize to him, I mean. You guys probably don't care. But I apologize for hitting him. Wasn't his fault, he was just in the way. Oh, gosh. Ow. He just friggin' facebustered me. I think I'm dead. I can't move. I need to get back in the ring now. Like, right now. Get up, please. Oh, okay, we got him. We hurt him pretty bad with those illegal weapons. That's nice. Yeah, Jeff Jarrett, he was Mr. Guitar Breaky Guy. Other than, I suppose, Honky Tonk Man was the original Guitar Breaky Guy, right? But Jeff Jarrett did it as well. But he thought that he was the best wrestler ever, and I suppose he's still... Dude, can you get off of me? Come on, get up. Just get out of there, Bob and Fishy. Gosh. Come on. There we go. We got him. Okay. Let's go ahead and see if we can do something with this. Get him center of the ring. Ow. Whoop. Ha ha, you missed. It's too bad the ref was like way in the way for that. Because that was a good shot of like me dodging his retaliation attack. Come on, make him submit. That'd be amazing. Or at least just get me some finisher meter. Ah, he broke out. Or ref can just get in the way again. Freaking Ian Collins, what are you doing? He just gets right up in between everything. Like, I get that that's what the ref is sort of supposed to do. Like, he's supposed to be in the middle of everything so that he can officiate properly. But when you're getting hit, when you just shouldn't be, come on. Oh my gosh. That's seriously on you. I might have to lower the difficulty if I can't get a win here. I think I raised it too soon. I think I was on hard and I had just had it on like, maybe, I don't know. Like I said, I hadn't played in a while. Maybe I was testing the next difficulty up and I don't know, confused myself. I don't know, but maybe lowering it back down to very hard from extremely hard here is my best course of action. If I can't get a win here, if I lose this match, or if I like don't win this match, maybe I'll lower it. Maybe. Ow. Okay. Come on, jump. There we go. Got him with a flying knee to the face. Come on, ref. Go. Go. Two. Oh, come on. He kicked out, but I kicked him in the... What the heck? He punched me in the friggin' pivot leg. There we go. Come on. There. Come on. Just hit him. Oh my. I only hit him with like one of those punches, which is really annoying. Ref, move. Get out of the way. I respect that being a ref is difficult. It's a difficult job. But you need to respect that I'm also in the middle of a difficult situation with lots of adversity. We hit him. He's going to kick out. No, he didn't kick out. We won. Okay. You can't see me, Jerry Buckler. Get out of my ring. We won. Okay, good. I was going to say, like, that was monumentally frustrating. If I didn't win, I'd have cried. Nah, I probably wouldn't have cried. But I'd have felt bad. So, got at least one more match out of this, I think. Let me check the time. Yeah, 15 minutes in, we got another match out of this. What does Hustle Hayes want? I have any referees to carry each match on tonight's show? Yeah, you know what? Let's referee a match. Why not? It's money, and I need $3 million. So, we're going to do it. Sure, I'll referee a match. I knew I could trust you with the responsibility, but it'll be good for you. Yeah, cool. It'll be good for me to have lots of money. You guys know I like my money. So, we got our guy in here. So, let's talk about some YouTube while we're doing this. Ah, it's Chi Guy. Whatever, skip your entrance. Let's talk about some of the other stuff that I've been uploading. Because, I upload a lot of videos, if you guys didn't know. So, like I was saying before, Pokemon is my favorite thing to upload. Just because I think it's, let's check if he's going to submit here. It's just my favorite game to play. My Digimon series is going to be wrapping up soon. I've actually already finished recording the season finale. I want to say it'll go up tomorrow or something. Or, I mean, not season finale, but series finale. So, that was incredibly fun to record. I do just absolutely love, like, those kind of RPG type of things. Ow. Check him. This is probably an awkward situation for Mr. Zanzibar there. I really have been enjoying all the different things that I've been recording. Otto and I did those Beyblade series. We also did, Mario Golf Toadstool Tour. And a bunch of other one-offs and stuff. Otto is a very good friend of mine, so always fun to record with him. He's such a wacky dude. I definitely enjoyed all that stuff. Beyblades were something from my childhood, so, like, being able to, record that was definitely a treat. Thing is, they weren't something from Otto's childhood, so he, didn't grow up with them. And you kind of do have to grow up with them to really understand what the heck you're doing. By the way, that was a really interesting move. I wonder if that would be possible in real life. Oh, get freaking clobbered. That was super fun to record. I don't know what episode will be going up by the time this episode goes live, but... hopefully you guys are enjoying... Anybody who watches that is enjoying that. I certainly enjoyed recording it, and that's all that really matters. Because that's the thing, it's not like this is my job. This is something I do because it's fun. I record stuff that I enjoy playing. Or, enjoy doing. Same reason that I do all those Pokemon videos and the Pokemon itself as well as the openings and stuff. It's stuff that I would be doing even if I wasn't recording. Wrestling Revolution, another game that I probably would be playing around with every now and then even if I wasn't recording it. So, got a guy outside. Give him a one. Give him a two. Give him a two. So, all this stuff, it's just, stuff that I have fun doing. So, hopefully anybody who, and that's the thing, I never expect anybody to watch all these other series if it doesn't appeal to them. A lot of, YouTubers are like, oh, I only record, this and this series because it gets a lot of views. Or, because I feel like it would, be good for, to help my channel grow. It's like, no, I don't care about that. It's all just what I enjoy doing. It's all stuff that I would be doing even if I wasn't recording. And if people enjoy it, cool. So, But anyways, for anybody who does enjoy that, glad you do. Yeah, cool. That's really all I wanted to talk about. Oh gosh, what just happened there? Some violence just happened there. Maybe I should like call this match like an announcer. I feel like I would be just a horrible. Oh, got an ankle lock by Chi Guy on Zanzibar here. Will Zanzibar tap? He's right in the center of the ring. Chi Guy is really doing some twisting on that ankle. That's gonna be incredibly painful. Oh, Zanzibar managed to break out, but just got hit with a huge drop kick by Chi Guy. Chi Guy's got a lot of momentum behind his attacks here, and he goes for a Hurricane Rana over the top rope. Zanzibar's been stunned there momentarily. They've got to watch out there. They don't want to get counted out. Sorry, that's my Michael Cole. I would never be able to do a JR, but Michael Cole, I feel like he's a bit more realistic and something I could aspire to be. A lot of people really hate Michael Cole. I never really hated him. I think that goes back to by the way, I'm just at this point I'm just going to talk about wrestling in general. Oh, got a pin. One. Sorry, Chi Guy. Oh. That's a rope. Oh. Ooh, that's a rope break as well. Zanzibar, you gotta get out of that corner. Zanzibar, that's a rope break too. Gotta get away from the ropes, bro. I think I just fell over. I love being able to just kind of like roll around the ring. Like, hop, hop, roll. Rope break. So, yeah, like back when I was a kid watching wrestling, when I first started watching wrestling, first announcers I heard, and because I was only allowed to watch SmackDown, so I grew up with Cole and Taz, and people say like, oh, Taz is the worst announcer ever. I thought he was cool. He knew a lot. A lot of what he said was kind of goofy at the time, too. Oh, almost. Chi Guy almost had him there. A lot of what he said was pretty goofy, but it's right. For example, Taz was the one who taught me that the neck grab before a choke slam is called a goozle, which I didn't know. But and people always were like, oh, that's the dumbest thing ever. But you look it up, that's really what it's called. Which is, doesn't make it any less dumb, I suppose, but still. That is the official. Oh, got. Probably gonna be going for some punches here. It's impressive that, Zanzibar's sunglasses have stayed on this entire match. It's not an easy thing to do, keeping those guys on. But, anyways. Oh, Chi Guy's probably about ready for a finisher if he gets up. And that might do it. We're all kind of like smushed together here. Whoop. One. Oh, just the one. Poor guy. Whoop. Hurricane Rana. That's a rope break. Chi Guy, hit your finisher. That's a rope break too, buddy. Chi Guy, hit it. That's a rope break too, bro. You gotta do a move. That's gonna be a rope break, bro. Oh, nope, he's not. He actually moved him out. Good for him. Good for him. He's a smart Chi Guy. Only takes four rope breaks to figure out that the guy's touching the rope. But yeah, there are a lot of interesting, unique things about wrestling that you don't know. But Taz, I always thought he had pretty good psychology for, you know, like a lot of his, him calling the matches and stuff. I don't know, I thought he was pretty. Oh, Chi Guy wins. Good for him. Well, poor Zanzibar. Well, he can't blame me. He tapped. Yep. Poor Zanzibar. It's okay. You'll get him next time, I assume. Or you won't. Whatever. Chi Guy seemed pretty tough. We'll have to. Actually, I know he's pretty tough. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and end this episode here. If I remember, next time I'll talk about some more of wrestling when I was a kid. Because it was interesting back then. It's still interesting, but... Uh-oh. Why do they settle their differences? Silk Siren. She's Alexa Bliss, who I'm in love with. Why? Why did you pull out of our match? Becky Lane, or whatever your name was. I think she was Becky Lynch, right? Or, you know, like the spoof of her. Whatever. Wonder who I'm going to be fighting. Ian Tense. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and end this episode here. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you later, guys. Bye.